Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. EA are up to something, guys, because we have got our hands on the full, what we believe to be the full EAFC 24 database with all the new players, ratings, stats, even skill move and weak foot and positions for like every single card in FC 24. We're going to take a look at a lot of that information today and also tell you how you might be able to find some cheap, overpowered beasts for starter teams in this database today. So a lot of that, of course, FIFA 23 content on the way out. We got to talk about a couple of things, especially because our beloved 85x10 actually expires today, but I'm not worried. I'll let you know a little bit more about that later in the video. If you're excited for the video today, drop a thumbs up on it. Subscribe if you're new. Let's go right into the FC 24 content, because again, today's one of those videos where we're talking FC 24 and FIFA 23 since we're in this limbo mode right now. This was tweeted out a few hours ago by Foot Scoreboard saying it took a bit longer than expected, but here is our entire FC 24 database. And this is the link. It takes you basically to what EA posts in, you know, a couple days from now, probably, is a full database with all cards in the game with their dynamic images, their stats, in-game stats, and everything for all these guys. You can see 5-star skills, 4-star weak foot for a new 95 icon Pele with different stats than what his base, mid, and prime all had, right? That's what this is. Now, where do they get these stats? Pretty sure, guys, that they are getting these stats from Foot Scoreboard, like actually from EA. Foot Scoreboard tweets out pack code. He doesn't tweet out leaks, really, except for stuff that's added to the game. At least that's how he's been operating during FIFA 23. So these are basically, I would say, confirmed and actual. All of the leaks that he had earlier that we looked at in yesterday's video, some in-depth leaks that we looked at with icons and heroes, those are all confirmed with stats that are in this database. So to me, this is the actual database for FC 24, and I think it's legit. Now let's look through a couple of these cards here. First of all, I want to look at Mbappe and show you guys something. Now, how this works is there's a search bar at the top, and you can type in players' names, or you can just kind of scroll down and it'll load more players, and then you can click on more, or you can download, I believe, a picture straight away from here. But you can click on more over here, and it pops up the in-game stats from the database for each and every single card, right? Mbappe 91 rated, we knew that from the other leagues. 97 pace, 90 shooting, and this is where it gets really interesting, right? You can compare this 91 Mbappe has 90 shooting, right? That was a +1 over last year's card. He has 93 attack positioning and 94 finishing. If we compare it to last year FIFA 23, 92 positioning, 93 finishing, and 88 shot power. So he actually got +2 shot power, 1 positioning, and 1 finishing. Now, there's one crazy thing with this Mbappe card that I want to show you. Look at physicality, guys. 78 physical, which is a +2 boost over FIFA 23. 77 jumping Mbappe had in FIFA 23. Look at his rating in FC 24. +11 jumping. I don't know if this guy got some hops or something over this last year, or if EA have to fine tune the stats for whatever new meta or whatever game mechanics are coming into FC 24. But from 77 jumping to 88, that is ridiculous. And I have not found too many other cards with jumping boosts that big. So I don't know if it's a change that's happening across the board inside of these players, but that is absolutely crazy, right? I want to take a look at Messi as well, because Messi is a big name player that we all want to try and get our hands on in the early game. It's actually kind of interesting. Messi got a -1, right, from FIFA 23 to FC 24, but a lot of his stats are almost like the exact same. If we take a look at Lionel Messi, he's got 87 acceleration and 76 sprint speed on his FIFA card. He's got 87 acceleration again, but they just downgraded his sprint speed by 2 in-game stats. He also got a jumping boost from, he's going to be 71 jumping in FC 24. He had 68 in FIFA 23. But I looked through a bunch of other cards like Ronaldo, who got a big stat downgrade. His jumping is down. Vinicius Jr., I looked at his jumping was down. So maybe there's other cards that got big jumping boosts, but that's kind of the thing that you can notice. And this is really where you can get nerdy with it a bit too, is start to dive into the details. Look for the cards that you want to look at. I was searching up some US men's national team players a little bit earlier. Search up players from your favorite team. Just get in here. Like, yes, I'm looking at all the 90 rated cards right now, but there's everything down to the bronzes and the silvers and everything in between inside of this database. So I do want to look through at a few other things though that I've noticed. And one of the first things that I see here at the top is, like we mentioned in yesterday's video, the icons are looking a lot different this year. Take a look at 94 R9. Of course, 94 R9, we always attribute it to be his mid version, right? It's still 94 rated. It has a different image though. They're using the image off of the prime cards for what we knew in old FIFAs as the prime versions, but they're giving them lower ratings because again, we only have one version of icons dropping at the start of FC24, and then they're getting promo icons after that. So 94 R9 is gonna look like the prime R9 with its dynamic image or the face shot of what we knew as prime R9, but then he's got 94 pace, 94 shooting, 94 dribbling, and 79 passing. So it's actually, for a lot of these icons, it's kind of a stat compilation that's in between their mid and base versions. R9's mid last year, 93, 93, 93. So we actually got a stat upgrade over his mid card from last year on pace, shooting, and dribbling, but he got minus 5 physical, 80 physical in FIFA 23 on his mid card. He's only got 75 on his icon card in FC 24. So very confusing how they're doing this. I saw somebody tweet earlier yesterday that Vanderstar got absolutely destroyed. Like, they really downgraded his speed and some of his other stats on his card. And that's unfortunate. I haven't looked through a lot of these other icons. Like, I don't know if Garincha 92, like how he compares to his mid card. I'm comparing a lot of these to the mid versions because I think that's the rating that EA went with. Like, 92 Garincha was the mid Garincha in FIFA 23. He had 90 pace, 94 dribble. This one has 89 pace and 94 dribble. So it looks like a lot of these are close to the mid versions, but they're definitely not exactly the same. There's a lot of differences with these. So that's a big, big thing with icons. And you can kind of look down the list here and see that some of them got upgrades in some areas. Like, this Gerd Muller looks really cracked. 92 rated, 86 pace, 92 shooting, and 84 dribbling. I don't even remember what Muller's prime card was this last year. I guess it was 94, so the 92 kind of makes sense for him. But he's got 86 pace compared to his mid only having 84 last year. And so I don't know. It's just weird, right, with how these ratings look. And it's a whole new year for icons and everything. So I wanted to talk about that. And guys, we can't not talk about some of these ratings without looking through some really overpowered cards, even some of the ones that we've already known the ratings of that were in like the top 50 release. Like, you take a look at maybe like Messi as we did, or maybe you take a look at the Benzema that we just went past, or Vinny Jr., man. Vinny Jr. looks amazing, guys. 89 finishing. That's a big upgrade for Vinny Jr. and 82 shooting overall. He still has 79 composure though, which is a bit unfortunate. And this is what I love doing. I love comparing to the card in FIFA 23 just to see how big the upgrade was. What was his composure? 79. They didn't upgrade his composure at all. That's a bit unfortunate, to be honest. But 89 finishing and 87 attack positioning, that's up from 82 and 84 in FIFA 23. That's why I love this database, to look at some of that and also to find some new cheap beasts, which I'm going to show you how to do that in a second. But also, one of the biggest points of emphasis out of this database release is, guys, some of the women's cards that EA have added in are absolutely crazy. And this is the hot topic of FC24, 100%. Look at this Alexis Putellas card, guys. Five star with three stats, 90 and above with 92 composure. That's going to be one of the best midfielders in the game. Like, those stats are insane. Right now, personally, I don't know a lot of these players, right? I haven't spent a ton of time watching women's football. I've watched more over the summer in the World Cup, but I don't know a ton of these players. But just like the men's players, guys, for a lot of these that have been added, some of these women have insane stats. It's just like when they add men's players to the game, some are really cracked and some are really not that usable. It's that same sort of mix, and some of them are going to be meta, and a lot of people are going to want to try to get them into their teams. If you've seen the Putellas card that we just looked at, that card looks insane. And this Barcelona striker, Oshawala, I'm butchering the name, but 91 pace and just pace like that at the beginning of the game with an 85 rated card, that's going to look like a very, very overpowered women's card that a lot of people are going to want to use. And since it is a hot topic and it's just something brand new with all the change this year coming to FC24 in this area, I just encourage you guys to view it as an opportunity to like learn about the beautiful game of football. Yes, change causes controversy and conversation, and a lot of people aren't going to like it. But you know, we have a lot of change in FIFA and EAFC every single year anyway. And change is just kind of part of life, you know? So I would just say to you, enjoy the parts of the game that you want to enjoy. And if that includes some of these brand new women's cards, then try them out, enjoy them, learn more about the beautiful game. But if you're not a huge fan of it, that's fine as well. There's still tons of men's players out there. It's still going to be the same ultimate team as a backbone with all of the same players that we're used to anyway. It's just like they added more on. That's the way that I'm choosing to think of it. And yes, I'm curious to learn more and see more as we get closer to the game. But I didn't want to just gloss over that fact today, because the fact is, if you take a look in here at a lot of these cards that have been added, especially for some of these women's players that we're just seeing now for the first time, Sophia Smith, 4-star, 5-star, absolutely cracked looking card, man. So from a FIFA meta perspective, it looks like some of these cards are going to be pretty usable. Now let's get back into the fun of the database a little bit more and look through a couple of hidden gems, guys. And I found one early yesterday, of course, and I was searching up some Spurs players. I was really looking forward to seeing what Van de Ven's rating is going to be, because this is one of the biggest and most fun parts about the database every single year at the beginning of the year, is figuring out what kind of cheap players we're going to be wanting to building our starter teams and starter squads around. Look at this Van de Ven card, man. I mean, we know he's fast, right? Transferring to Spurs, he was the fastest man in the Bundesliga last year. 85 pace, 80 physical, and 79 defense, but 78 rated. That's a card that looks like it's going straight into my starter team. It's probably going to be like Lacroix. That was what I tweeted yesterday. I said the next Lacroix, that's what he reminds me of. Probably going to be like 15, 20, 30,000 coins in the first week or two of the game, and then drop off a bunch in price like crazy. But that's part of the fun. Here's a couple more. Shout out to Bikelme on Twitter. He found this Ibanez from the Saudi League. 85 pace, 82 defense, and 81 physical. That's an insane starter center back card. He's going to be one a lot of people are going after at the beginning of the game. Nico Williams, 4-star, 5-star, is a 79 rated gold card with 93 pace. I mean, pace is all that he's got going for him, but what a card right there for an early game. And then not a lot of people have probably seen this one, guys. Shout out to Nerez on Twitter, finding a Galatasaray right back. Sasha Bowie's official rating, 86 pace, 84 physical. This might be the go-to French right. Everybody's looking for like French right backs at the beginning of a new EA Sports game, ultimate team. Those links are very coveted. This card right here looks to be that guy for an early game right back, especially if you need those French links. So that's an insane card. Now, unfortunately, you can't search in here for like ratings, really. You can't search in here for like different nationalities or different positions. It's all by searching like the player names. So, like if I want to search up Barella's card, I have to type Barella and then I see more, right? Or, you know, stuff like that. So it's not the easiest to actually go through and try to find a French left back or center back that would maybe be really good for your team. But you know, you go through and you find a few cards in here by searching up their names. You guys kind of know like some of the meta cards that we're going to be looking out for. Look at Upamecano, 83 pace. This is an upgrade, by the way, 83 pace for Upamecano with a nice split for lengthy, really good sprint speed there to catch up on defense, and then 91 jumping for him. Let's just do this really quick because I'm really curious about this jumping stat now that I've noticed this. Did he get an upgrade in jumping? 87 to 91. I mean, he got a +2 overall, so, or +1 overall from an 81 to an 82. So maybe it's good that they're boosting the jumping of the defenders if they're boosting Mbappe that much too, because there's got to be some counteracting of that stat upgrade there. But that's kind of how I would look through a lot of these cards. Of course, guys, we got to do a Renato Sanchez check, and the Renato Sanchez card looks as, you know, terrorizing as ever. 4-star, 4-star, 78 rated. He is playing for Roma now, so he's in the Serie A, but that is an amazing Renato Sanchez card, let's be completely honest. And Serie A starter teams are always looked at as kind of the cheap league, especially last year, with Renato being in that league this year, you know, and a lot of other really cracked cards that I've seen so far in the Serie A, like Cavaradona, stuff like that, Osimhen, people can build to. Serie A might not be the cheapest of starter leagues this year, even though that's kind of what people see it as. So enjoy this ratings, all of these ratings here, guys. Again, Foot Scoreboard, credit to them for having this. I do believe that EA is going to release something of their own very, very soon, so be watching out for that, and it will be definitely easier to find hidden gems and find overpowered cards when EA actually release their own thing, because you'll be able to search by ratings, you'll be able to search by, you know, nationalities, by clubs, by leagues and everything. So I'm looking forward to that for sure. But with that moved out of the way, we got to talk about FIFA 23 just for a little bit, right? Because I'm still grinding. I got to get my Kane SBC done. I'm playing my games. Actually, I'm just, you know, AFK in squad battles right now to get my 82 times 10 in FC 24 to try to pack some of those insane cards that we've seen stats of now. And today's a big day because our beloved 85 times 10, 84 times 10, and actually the 86 times 10 are all supposed to expire. But fear not, I don't believe they're going to go away forever. Just like we've seen the last couple of Mondays throughout footies, throughout preseason, I expect these SBCs to come straight back to us. The only hope is that EA, number one, don't mess it up like they did a couple of weeks ago and make the 85 times 10 requirements different and then make us all, you know, mad when the 85 times 10's not there for a day or two. And also, I hope that they release the 86 times 10 unlimited repeatable, right? I hope they don't change any of the ratings, and I also hope they don't mess it up. EA literally just hit the copy pasta button. If that's all that you need to do, that would be perfectly fine. The 86 times 10 doesn't have to be unlimited repeatable. It'd be cool if it was, but that's something that could happen today. That's one way they could change it. And yeah, we all need the 85 times 10 and the 86 times 10, more so the 85 10, still in the game to be crafting. That's a nice 94 rated variety right there. Wow, again, look at the fodder, man. It's absolutely fantastic. So we're still crafting. There's still stuff to do. Now, today, Monday, are we only going to get the SBCs that we're seeing refresh today? Or is EA, this is the last time I'm going to say it, is EA going to give us that 99 Messi? Because we need it. I've been saying it now for the past 3 days, and it hasn't happened yet. Ooh, Alvarez, that's a different one. 99 Messi, EA Sports. You did the Ronaldo. Where's Messi? Okay, where's the Neymar? It just makes sense for you to drop them. And this is the last time I'm going to say anything about it, because I feel like if I keep saying something about it every day, then the day that I don't say something about it, then they will actually drop it. So I'll test them one day longer. EA, drop it today, or else it's basically too late. Let's be completely honest. Like, how many of us really want to put in a shift to get a 99 Messi? Let's say 25 to 29 squads would be my guess again for a Messi card. Today's the 11th. And, you know, literally this game has 1 week left max. And then we are in a web app mode for FC 24. We're already starting to get into that kind of mode with the database being out. And really, like, the motivation is transferring slowly over to FC 24. Maybe it's not even that slow. So we need that SBC, EA. Okay, just do it. Don't mess around. Now, I didn't talk about the Openda. We did have an SBC yesterday. Not too much to go crazy about. 82 times 100, and also a brand new Openda. Speaking of overpowered players in FC 24, this guy is on the top of the list for overpowered strikers, especially with the links he's going to have. Let me show you his card here really quick. Openda looks really, really nice. This card, 5-star skill moves would have been nice. 97 rated. I mean, 99s are kind of the minimum right now. But on FC 24, we're looking at a 93 paced, 82 rated Openda that's got a 4-star weak foot at least, only 3-star skills, with 84 attack positioning and 83 finishing. So it's all about the pace. 93 jumping as well. I'm telling you guys, something's going on with jumping, man. Now, I know Openda got a massive upgrade. Let me look at jumping one more time. Yeah, he's going from a 75, of course, to an 82, so you're gonna see a boost here, I would imagine. What was his jumping last year? Oh, 92. Really? So his jumping went up plus one. I don't understand, man. And that's again another thing, including this with the whole the women being added. Ratings on EA's games, they've never made sense, guys, right? Some players you think should be higher rated are not. Some players you think are too high rated are not too high rated, and they should be lower rated. And some of the ratings on some of these cards just don't make sense. And that is a constant that has never changed. So as you're looking through a lot of these ratings, you might think that somebody should be higher or lower, but always remember that it's EA, and that's just kind of how it goes. So let me know down in the comments who you're the most excited for and some of your thoughts about the ratings, whatever they may be, whatever cards you're seeing through this that you're super duper excited about. Let me know down in the comments below. But I'll see you guys today on stream. We'll be looking through a bunch of ratings, trying to find some more overpowered fun cards together, and maybe doing a little bit of FIFA 23 crafting still as well, because I got to get that Harry Kane in my team. If you enjoyed the video today, drop a thumbs up on it, and of course subscribe if you're new for more videos coming out like this every single day. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. See you guys in the stream today. Peace out.